dear students, Jai Hind and very good morning. Welcome back to our e-learning session. As you all know, today you are going to attend our lecture number 8 in chapter number 4, that is carbon and its compounds. Before we start today's lecture, you have to be very sure regarding the topic which I explained in our previous lecture number 7. In lecture number 7, if you can remember, we have in detail discussed regarding nomenclature in organic compound. That is most important. Any structural formula presented in front of you, by just seeing that structural formula of any compound given to you, you should be able to make up for its particular chemical name by utilizing those rules which you have studied in nomenclature of organic compound. And as I told you yesterday in lecture number 7, that whatever rules regarding the nomenclature are given, those rules are no doubt important as an exam point of view, but they are actually general knowledge also, and that is going to help you a lot if you have understood them perfectly. And if you remember that perfectly, will help you a lot in future when you go in detail as far as organic chemistry is concerned. Now, my dear student, one more point. Till now, in lecture number 1 to 7, whatever you have attended, that was simply the basic of organic chemistry, where you understood the covalent nature of carbon, versatile nature of carbon. We discussed about 3 types of chain structure in carbon, that is linear, branched and ring-like structure. We discussed in detail about saturated and unsaturated compounds, where we discussed in detail about alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, and even we discussed about homologous series of alcohols and nomenclature. Whatever topic we have covered so far in organic chemistry are actually the basic topics of organic chemistry. Now, next topic which we are going to target in today's lecture are those topics which do not have any basic essence with strengthening your basic of organic chemistry, but just now the topics are simply narratives regarding properties of organic compound, properties of ethanoic acid, properties of ethanol. Actually, there are so many type of organic compound formed, but we will discuss about two only in detail. So in today's topic, actually we are going to discuss in detail about chemical properties of organic compound. That is what we are going to study today in detail. And my dear student, one more thing which I always insist you is that anytime, whenever, if you just read our material, I have always found it little deficit in the depth of the content. The content hasn't been given in depth. So it may happen that in our material which we have prepared, you find the detailed discussion regarding and in our material we have included few different examples also which are not mentioned in textbooks. So that's why again insistence for material reading. You may refer textbook, it's all okay, but reading of material and preparing the topic in detail from material is a must for you. That you need to understand. Okay, dear student, let us start our today's topic. Okay, before I start, let us mention the title of the chapter again, chapter number 4. Okay, and what is the title of the chapter? Carbon and its compounds. Okay, dear student, carbon and its compounds. Okay, and in this particular chapter, after covering so many topics, today you are attending your lecture number 8. Okay, and today we are going to discuss the topic of properties of organic compound. That's the topic we are going to discuss today. Understand, it happens that such question may be altogether sometime asked in exam, and maybe they are asked separately also, because we are going to study four chemical properties of organic compound that we are going to study. One more thing, when we are discussing all properties of organic compounds, you need to understand all properties in detail, so that if any MCQ one line true false are asked from these properties, you should be able to answer them. Okay, so my dear student, today's topic which we are starting is, just let me make the number and title of the topic, 4.3, which we are discussing, and title of the topic is properties of organic compound. Organic compound, understand, four properties we have to discuss in detail one by one. Understand, four properties of organic compound we are going to discuss in detail. The first property let us discuss. Okay, title of the property itself will collect the material in your mind immediately. And that's the title of the topic, one very important property, that is combustion. Not a new word, easily understandable, understood, and my dear student, all organic compounds are easily combustible. They burn easily. Some of the organic compounds you all know, they burn very easily and produces heat and light. Take an example. We have taken one chemical reaction. If you can remember chapter number 4, understand, suppose just to assess out the organic compound, we say alkane, alkenes, alkynes, alcohols, aldehyde, esters, ketone, etc. In all this organic compound, I must mention that the first 4 compound I mentioned, they all are good fuels. Either you can take alkane, alkene, alkynes, or alcohol. Just try to understand, to mention some of the alkanes: methane, ethane, propane, butane. All are good fuels. You have understood this reaction also already. So all organic compounds, to mention some of the alkanes, I just now mentioned the name: methane, ethane, propane, butane. Alkenes are also good fuel. At the same way, alkynes and alcohols, all are good fuels. We have already property, if you remember that chemical reaction in chapter number 1, when methane burns, you understood this, is combines with oxygen, if you can remember that reaction, and forms carbon dioxide, water, as well as heat and light energy. Okay. Now, my dear student, just try to understand balancing and all that you have already understood. Okay, Emato, so just place here 2 and 2 here. It is balanced. Basic is not balancing, because that is what you understood already. Understand, when we have done that chapter number 1, basic is that any alkane, when burns, they are good fuels and produces lots of heat energy and light energy. This is, I just have shown one of the chemical reaction of methane. Otherwise, if you all know regarding butane also. Butane, my dear student, you all know butane is already one of the most established efficient fuel available in market. And that butane is also one of the good fuel used in liquefied form in LPG cylinder. Not only that, my dear student, alkenes are also good fuel, alkynes are also, but the basic is that all alkanes which are saturated hydrocarbon burns completely with blue flame means their complete combustion will take place. That is not the case with alkenes and alkynes. If you burn alkenes and alkynes, which are actually unsaturated hydrocarbons, so they do not burn completely. When you try to burn them, they burn with orange flame. That means incomplete combustion will take place. Not only that, they burn with orange flame at the same time. It also produces lots of smoke. We can sometimes call they burn with sooty flame, understand? Because incomplete combustion takes place. Many times you have seen that your cooking vessel, bottom of the cooking vessel becomes blackened. That is the deposit of the soot form due to incomplete combustion of fuel. So mostly unsaturated hydrocarbons do not burn completely. Understand? And even one more thing, even saturated hydrocarbon like alkane also need enough sufficient supply of oxygen to burn. If they do not get enough supply of oxygen, they do not burn completely. Understood? So this is clear. Combustion, even my dear student, all alcohols, all are also good fuel. Understood? And one of the most alcohols, though we all know, methanol, ethanol, propanol, butanol, pentanol, all are alcohols. But out of all the alcohols, the most popular alcohol is ethanol. So ethanol is also one of the good fuel. It also burns easily and produces heat and light. That also you can mention ethanol, CH3CH2OH, okay? When ethanol burns, it also produces carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Understand? So alcohols are also good fuel. Coming to the basic concept of the properties, that all organic compounds are generally good fuel. It may happen in the there are some marginal difference in their efficiency as a fuel. Some marginal difference are going to be there, like unsaturated hydrocarbon do not burn completely, but saturated hydrocarbon burn completely. So that way, some marginal differences are going to be there. You understood this? So this way, we got idea regarding the property of combustion of organic compound. Just to summarize, all organic compounds are good fuels that you should mind. Okay, so this is the first property of organic compound we have discussed. Understood? Ethyl alcohol or ethanol is a good fuel. You know one thing, even ethyl alcohol, when burned, because it's a good fuel, it also sometimes work as an antiseptic. Suppose you are somewhere in forest or at war, it happened that you got some injury, and there are chances that the injury which you got, understand, is going to be septic. So at that time, if you just pour some alcohol and burn it, that will work as an antiseptic. So all alcohols are good fuels. And so this is clear, this property that is called combustion. Okay, my dear student, let us discuss the next property. Okay, combustion we have discussed. Okay, next property that which we are going to discuss is again very important property of organic compound, that is 4.3.2. The property which we are going to discuss now, that is actually called oxidation. Name never new for you, oxidation. Is oxidation. In fact, we discussed in detail about redox reaction in chapter number 1. That means you all know the meaning of oxidation. Oxidation means what? So, addition of oxygen is known as oxidation reaction. It is already clear in our mind. Understand? Now, my dear student, here we are going to discuss about property of oxidation in organic compound. Okay, just try to understand properties of oxidation. All organic compound can get oxidized easily. But my dear student, one thing has to be very clear in your mind. For oxidation, you require some oxidizing agent. What is the role of those oxidizing agent? They actually oxidizes other compound and reduces themselves. You understood in 9th standard. Oxidizing agent and reducing agent. What is the role of oxidizing agent? The oxidizing agent oxidizes other and reduces themselves. Just try to understand one of the oxidation reaction in organic compound. Okay, let us take one example to better understand it. Suppose, my dear student, let us take, suppose CH3, CH2OH, it is the formula of what? It is the formula of ethanol or ethyl alcohol is oxidized in presence of some of the oxidizing agent mentioned. Understand, suppose I mention alkaline potassium permanganate, you all know KMnO4. Alkaline, you know, understand, or some other oxidizing agent whose name you should remember, acidified, that means alkaline, acidified K2Cr2O7, that is potassium dichromate. Okay, so dear student, when alcohol is oxidized by very strong oxidizing agent like alkaline acidified potassium permanganate or potassium dichromate, so when its oxidation take place, oxygen is added, and addition of oxygen molecule here will give rise to a new compound, that is ethanoic acid. Understand? This is ethanoic acid formed, understood as an oxidation of alcohol. This was ethyl alcohol. I can in short say ethanol, okay? This is what we say ethanoic acid, okay? So what happened during the oxidation reaction? Alcohols turned into respective acid. If we have taken methanol, it would have formed methanoic acid. Propanol would have formed propanoic acid. Understand, this is oxidation reaction of organic compound. And one more thing, whenever you internal sub questions can be asked from this, just you note it down. Suppose I do not want to ask you directly a question, right? I do not want to ask you explain oxidation of organic compound. Suppose I do not want to ask you as oxidation of organic compound, how can I ask the same question? I can ask it as a twister. Explain formation of organic acid from alcohol. Thank you, question. Explain formation of organic acid from alcohol. Understand, that means you have to explain that oxidation of ethanol will form one of the acid. Understand? Second question, which when you understand every property in detail can be asked. Second question, what are oxidizing agent? Name any two. So again, those chemical compounds oxidizes other substances are known as oxidizing agent. To mention some name, alkaline KMnO4, that is potassium permanganate, and acid K2Cr2O7, that is, can be asked. Again, still one more. How is ethanoic acid prepared from ethanol? Such twisting question can be asked. Understand, that's why when you study any chemical property, you have to be very, very sure how to answer that, and you should be able to extract out questions from that. Understand, you need to be very concentrated and extract out questions from that. That is very, very necessary for you. Understood? So second property, my dear student, that is oxidation, okay? Let us take another property, organic compounds, okay? Some other properties of organic compound, the third one we are taking. This property you need to understand, okay, in detail. Third property, Let me mention the name of this property. That is, the property is called addition reaction. Addition reaction. Just try to understand addition reaction. As I mentioned, when we were discussing about saturated and unsaturated compound, understand, that means we were discussing about alkanes, alkenes, alkynes. Alkanes are saturated, alkenes and alkynes are unsaturated. At that time, one thing has to be very clear in our mind, that all saturated compound, that is alkane, never undergo addition reaction. Addition reaction are never possible in any saturated compound. Addition reaction are possible only with unsaturated compound. They are possible only with unsaturated compound, that is either alkenes or alkynes. They are all both unsaturated compounds. Suppose, just to understand this particular chemical property, let me mention the same example which they have given in textbook. In textbook, what they have explained, addition reaction means what? Addition reaction means to add something in already existing compound. That is called addition reaction. So actually what happens, whenever any unsaturated compounds undergo addition reaction, it turns into saturated compound. Suppose, just take an example, vegetable oil. Vegetable oil means it has nothing to do with vegetable. Vegetable oil means the groundnut oil which we all eat. So vegetable oil is actually what? Vegetable oil is actually a long chain of unsaturated fatty acids only. This vegetable oil, when undergo addition reaction with hydrogen, vegetable oil is already in liquid form, that you all know. But when it undergoes addition reaction with hydrogen, what happens? It turns into saturated compound. Means actually it solidifies and forms what we call vegetable ghee, or sometime we use the word in commonplace, dalda ghee. So that vegetable ghee is produced by actually addition reaction of vegetable oil with hydrogen. Understand, they mentioned in textbook, suppose oil, as you all know, are long chain of unsaturated fatty acids. Suppose I just show you fatty acid, suppose unsaturated. Understand, here I am showing R. R means any hydrocarbon part present in this, okay? When it undergoes addition reaction with hydrogen happens actually between two carbon, there is double bond, that you all know. And remember one thing very clearly, whenever there is double covalent bond, one bond is always weaker. So during addition reaction, out of the two covalent bond, one of the weaker bond will break. Suppose here, just we imagine that this weaker bond must have suppose broken. Now, when any weaker bond breaks, it actually ensures two valences available by each carbon atom, means they are able to share their electron with hydrogen. So what happens? Whenever addition reaction takes place, one weak bond breaks, and as a result, it converts into saturated compound this way. R, one valency free, is covalently bonded by hydrogen, okay? And this is what you call saturated compound. Understand that is vegetable ghee is formed. Vegetable ghee is formed, understand, from vegetable oil. So this is one of the addition reaction. To increase the rate of this addition reaction, nickel catalyst is used. Understand, nickel catalyst play a very important role in this particular addition reaction. This of converting vegetable oil into vegetable ghee is industrially utilized for making vegetable ghee in large amount. Understand? So this is one of the important property of organic compound, that is addition reaction. And one more thing here, my dear student, this process of converting vegetable oil into vegetable ghee is also known one particular name which you need to remember, and that is actually called, understand, the name of this particular process is hydrogenation. You should remember this word, hydrogenation. This can be also asked in exam. What is actually hydrogenation? But that's the process. Suppose let us discuss some queries which can be asked from this particular property. First, though, my dear student, title itself, explain addition reaction. Understand, I can mention one reaction also. Suppose to test your knowledge in exam, if they ask you, explain addition reaction of ethene and bromine, suppose they ask. So actually I already explained you that ethene is one of the unsaturated compound, that you all know. Suppose in exam you are asked, explain addition reaction of ethene and bromine. Just, my dear student, try to concentrate. Ethene, you all know, C2H4, that we all know. Now, ethene suppose when reacts with bromine, what happens actually? When ethene reacts with bromine, as I already told you, whenever addition reaction take place, one of the weaker bond is going to break. So the out of the two bond, one weaker bond will break and ensures two valences available for carbon itself. Understand? And actually when two valences become available for carbon, one of the bromine atom will introduce on this carbon atom and one on this. How the result will look like? It is like this: H, one bromine here. Now it converts into saturated, one bromine here. So a totally new compound has been formed. Understand, this was ethene and this is called, try to name it, if you can remember the nomenclature. Two carbon means it is going to be ethane. How many bromine atom here? If one, you will say bromoethane, but actually two bromines, so you can say dibromoethane. But because first bromine atom is on first carbon, second bromine atom is on second carbon, so my dear student, the nomenclature looks like this: 1,2-dibromoethane. Try to understand this. 1,2-dibromoethane is formed from ethene. Understood? Actually, it is dibromoethane, but nomenclature says that because the first bromine atom appeared on the first carbon and the second appear on the second carbon. That's why you have to be very precise and specific in naming like 1,2-dibromoethane. Okay? So this can be asked, though it is not mentioned in your textbook. Okay? Now one more thing in detail. How can the same question be asked? First, explain hydrogenation or explain vegetable ghee from vegetable oil, can be asked. What is hydrogenation, can be asked. Which catalyst is utilized in hydrogenation reaction, that is nickel catalyst. So this way MCQs can be generated. Understood? And whenever such MCQ come before you, you have to be very concentrating on that. Okay? Then and then you're able to justify your answer. So this is addition reaction, one of the third property of organic compound. Okay? Fourth property, let us discuss regarding organic compound. Okay, fourth property. Actually, fourth property we discussed, I think, somewhere in our topic explanation in the same chapter. Understand? We discussed somewhere in a nomenclature also. If you can remember, when one hydrogen atom is substituted by another functional group, it gives rise to a new compound. And yesterday I think we have understood bromoethane, bromopentane, chloroethane, chloropentane, chloropropane, anything can be. Understand? So substitution reaction, that's the fourth property in organic compound, that is substitution reaction. Okay, that's the fourth property, substitution reaction. What happens actually in substitution reaction? One more thing, substitution reaction are only possible with saturated compound, that is alkanes. They are not possible either with alkenes or alkynes. Remember it very well. Understood? So substitution reaction means what? It is possible only with saturated hydrocarbon, that is alkane. So actually there is nothing like any bond is going to break. But actually one of the atom needs to be substituted by another atom or group of atom, which we call heteroatom. So actually what happens? Whenever one hydrogen atom is substituted by another group of atom, it gives rise to a totally new compound. Suppose methane. When one hydrogen atom from methane is substituted by chlorine, it gives rise to chloromethane. Understand? Totally new reaction. Suppose methane, as you all know, CH4. When it reacts with chlorine, obviously in presence of sunlight, it is one type of photochemical type of chemical reaction. What happens? One hydrogen atom is substituted by chlorine and it gives rise to a new compound. Understood? That is called methyl chloride, CH3Cl. So totally new compound is formed simply by substitution of one hydrogen atom by another heteroatoms, mostly either halogens or alcohol, carboxylic acid, ketone, ester, or aldehyde group, and it gives rise to a totally new compound. So my dear student, this property is the fourth property in organic compound. So this question gets, this topic gets over here. So in exam, same question can be asked in four mark, like explain properties of organic compound. Same question can be splitted and asked in two marks. Explain combustion of organic compound, explain oxidation of organic compound, explain reduction of organic compound, explain substitution reaction of organic compound. This way the question can be asked. Okay, my dear student. So make the topic quite clear in your mind. Understand? And that way only you have to understand. And why we go always in particularly in detail in this chapter, in all other chapter also we go in detail, but this chapter, understand, is very important for higher standard also, and particularly for 10th also. In chemistry, this chapter is little difficult to remember and understand, right? So as my always suggestion in every lecture, whenever the lecture gets over, just revise the same topic from material in detail. Try to understand each and every word and gather yourself, understand, and prepare the short note thoroughly. This is the way you need to prepare it. Okay, my dear students, so in today's lecture, we have taken the topic of, which topic we have taken? Properties of organic compounds in detail. Okay, thank you very much from Bharat sir.